Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmoy Bishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. So today we are going to discuss an interesting multiple choice question or MCQ about heterocyclic compound. I believe such kind of MCQ could be very useful for your exams in the equivalence of bachelor, master or related competitive exam. So today's question is, this heterocyclic moiety, this indole fused with furan, you can see reaction of DMF PCl POCl3, what is the product? The question is, what is the major product of this reaction? In order to find the answer, four options are provided in front of you, and one of them is the correct answer. So you have to find out what is the correct answer. By the way, first I request you, please pause the lecture and try by yourself, and whatever answer you get, don't hesitate, write in the comment box. So in this way you can do self-evaluation, even I can understand how much you have understood. Okay, by the way, I've already uploaded lots of lectures on this heterocyclic chemistry topic. Please visit for further understanding. Okay, and today we'll discuss another question: what happened if excess of DMF PCpOCl3 could be used? And this is, by the way, another MCQ could be constructed. Okay, so in this video we will actually discuss two multiple choice questions. Okay, so I request you, please watch the complete video with full attention and cool mind, because it is essential. If you understand the problem properly, you will be able to succeed in the exam. So in order to understand the problem, first of all, I believe that you have tried the question by yourself. Now let's go to the main discussion. So in order to understand the problem, we first understand the nature of reagent, because if we understand this, whatever question will come, we will be able to answer the question. Okay, so here, in order to answer, first two things. First of all, reagent, that is POCl3 DMF, and the molecule. First, focus on this reagent POCl3 DMF. Okay, actually this is a combination. This combination is nothing but a Wilsmeyer-Hack reaction. These generates are electrophile for that purpose. How the reaction occurs? First of all, the nitrogen pushes its lone pair here, and ultimately the attack happens from the oxygen side. Now you may ask question that, sir, nitrogen is generally more nucleophilic, but why the attack happens from oxygen? First of all, nitrogen is little more bulky. See, two methyl groups are here, so this bulkiness is higher. Second, because of the resonance, the charge density, negative charge density in the oxygen is higher. Third point is, phosphorus oxygen bond is pretty strong. So these three factors are responsible for such kind of reactivity. So what will happen? First of all, it will open, it will come back, and one chloride will leave. So in this way, there will be a double bond formation and chloride leave. And in the next step, what will happen? See, just look at this part. This is a protonated imine type. Okay, so chloride ion will attack, means it will attack here. So just a nucleophilic acyl substitution type reaction. Okay, it will come open and it will come back and it will leave. Why? Because so final, in this way it will result this product, this one hydrogen. By the way, there was one hydrogen from the previous time. Okay, so this hydrogen and here chlorine, this is actually the electrophile, and by the way, this is a weaker electrophile. And what happens, why this left? Because the product is phosphorus oxygen ClCl. Now look at from the initial part. See, from initial we have started one Cl, and this Cl is replaced by one O minus, and actually this phosphorus oxygen bond is very strong because of very strong P pi D pi bonding, means this lone pair delocalized into the vacant d orbital of phosphorus in this way. Okay, so if you put sign, this is plus, minus, 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 plus, plus. So this, through this back bonding, you may consider this bond is very stable. So this part we understood. Now let's focus little bit on the moiety, this indole attached to furan. So three possible options are there. First of all, furan. So actually furan is a pi excess nucleus. Aromatic nucleus substitution preferred to happen on pi excess nucleus, 5-member heterocycles. And in case of furan, which is the preferred position? A for AES, this is C2. So C2 is the preferred position for furan. Another thing, this indole, just look at this part, indole derivative. we know that indoles prefer to have AES on C3 position. I know you will be a little surprised. By the way, I have already uploaded a dedicated lecture on this topic, reactions of indole. Okay, so it will prefer to undergo C3 substitution because in this way loss of resonance energy is minimum. Okay, so a aromatic electrical substitution on indole happened this C3 position. Fine. And another thing is that another possible option is that this benzene can react. Why? See, in this benzene there is one NH attached, aniline type derivative methane, and if it is, then why the reaction is preferred to occur this para position? Okay, this para position is preferred for this aromatic electrophilic substitution. Fine. And another site is available for reaction which we generally neglect, that is this NH. It can, in presence of acid base reaction, it can participate. By the way, during our reaction no bases are used, so we will not consider as acid, but by the way remember that they can act as an acid. Okay, so we have understood this. Now question, which one will react? By the way, if you look at very carefully, that indole has minimum RE compared to furan and pyrrole. So that is the reason the substitution will occur at C3. So first reaction on AES regarding using this electrophile will occur on C3. Okay, so let's discuss the mechanism of the process. So what happens? This electrophile, as we told previously, it will be produced and it will undergo AES at this position. So first of all, this will attack on this carbon. So acyl nucleophilic substituent reaction, Cl will leave. Okay, so this is, it will be the plus charge, and as a counter anion there is chloride. So in the next stage what happens? That this proton will be abstracted and aromaticity will gain. So ultimately this. Now how this cation is stabilized? First of all, stabilized through the conjugation of the nitrogen lone pair. Okay, means nitrogen lone pair can push here. So in this way, every atom in the molecule is octet filled, relatively stabilized. In the second part, aromaticity could be abstracted, means this proton, and it will come. And by the way, this molecule have some additional stabilization. Why I am saying this? Just look at, this is a styrene type derivative. Okay, this double bond at the benzylic position, so this benzene ring can also participate. But I believe you people understand this, and I have discussed this thing previously, so I am not going to discuss here. Fine. So in this case, a point to be remembered, that is furan, pyrrole, thiophene, they are acid sensitive, so workup needs to be done carefully, and we must be careful while using acid because we should not use very excess of acid, or we need to take care about the acid produced in this reaction. Okay, so that is the important thing, because I have discussed in another dedicated video that this furan, pyrrole or thiophene, they undergo polymerization selective addition reaction in presence of acid. Please visit if you are interested on that part of chemistry. Fine. So we have understood this part, how it is produced. So this is, see, actually a cationic imine derivative, and during the workup or in presence of water, they undergo hydrolysis of this part, and what happens? This NME removes and oxygen attached, and ultimately this part, means what do I mean, this part is converted into aldehyde. So what is the structure of the product? The final product is this, means this is our product of this reaction. Now, as the second question I have mentioned, excess POCl3-DMF, so same electrophile. Now question, AES will happen which position? Okay, just look at this molecule. Okay, just let me draw it here for a little bit better understanding. So this is NH, this is CHO, and this is furan. Now see, this indole's pyrrole part, this part is already substituted, so make further substitution here not possible. Okay, so not possible. Now which option left? Option number one is this furan, and option number two is benzene. Now always remember that 5-member heterocycles are highly reactive for AES due to this pi excess nature. They are pi excess nucleus, so AES will happen here. First, point number one we have understood. So what is the point number two? Point number two, AES will happen here, and it will happen at this position, Actually, this is a C2 type. So point number 2 is C2 substitution. Okay, because C2 substitution positive charge will come here, which is resonance stabilized highly. So this is the reason, that's why the reaction will occur and ultimately produce this disubstitution product. So substitution number 1 occurs on this indole, and if we use excess this Wilsmeyer-Hack reagent, substitution number 2 will occur on this pyrrole. Okay, so the answer of our question is that this in DMF the product is the first the major product of this reaction is B. Okay, and if you use excess, then the product is, this is CHO, then the product actually substitution on the furan side, just I have told. Okay, so this is okay. So two MCQ we have learned today's discussion. I believe it's a win-win from both point of view. So now let's discuss what you learned today. We learned today that AES on 5-member heterocyclic compounds occur efficiently than benzene due to pi excess nucleus. Because in case of benzene, 6 pi electron over 6 atoms means 6-member ring. Whereas in case of 5-member ring, they also have 6 pi electrons. This is for aromaticity, but over 5 atoms. Okay, that's why they call pi excess nucleus compared to benzene. So that's why they are more reactive for AES. Fine. Indole, which is indole, this benzene attached to this pyrrole. What do I mean? This is actually indole. Indole is more active in AES than corresponding furan and pyrrole, because the resonance stabilization energy of this pyrrole part is very less. We know the furan is least aromatic compared to pyrrole, furan and pyridine, pyrrole, furan and thiophene among these three. But this indole, which is fused with benzene, this pyrrole is fused with benzene, it has even further lesser RE than pyrrole or furan also. And this part I have discussed in a dedicated lecture on indole. Please visit if you want to learn more. Fine. So this is indole. That's why, since the RE is less, then it is more reactive for AES, and reaction occurs indole this position, that is C3. Okay. So, but whereas in case of furan, if you consider, that occurs on the C2 because of the greater stabilization of the sigma complex produced during the AES substitution. Okay. And one interesting point, that pyrrole, thiophene, furan are not stable in acid. We must be careful about that factor, and we must be cautious while dealing with them or during the workup process. Okay, so this is the end of this discussion. I hope this video may be interesting for you. If it is really helpful, then please like the lecture and write your opinion in the comment box, and obviously don't forget to write your answer in the comment box. And if you think it's worthy, then share with your friends, such that such kind of lecture may help them also for their exams. And most importantly, if you think my channel is providing good quality product, then subscribe this channel and please press the bell icon to get the update of every new videos I upload. So thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. Don't lose hope during this tough time, because this time will pass. Okay, so try to maintain your mental happiness and continuously study. One day we'll get success. So stay happy. See you in my next video. Bye bye.